Hi everyone. This is a short video about how my misunderstanding of LinuxCNC led to a ruined part. Here's the entire Fusion 360 toolpath. After another mistake I made recently, I've started to model my parts for cam in an assembly with device and parallels to enable a simulation to check for collision with the fixture. If we focus on a later part of the toolpath, we will see that the tool retracting to clear the rectangular boss. Something didn't sound right during that retract, and clearly the part is being clipped by the tool. This also happened on another side of the boss. I asked about this on LinuxCNC forums and was patiently referred to the G61 and G64 commands. These control whether the tool passes through every point, even if that requires the tool to stop, or if the tool can round a corner, possibly missing an endpoint of a line. By rounding the corners or merging short lines, operations can be made smoother and the velocity of the tool maintained. By default, G64 is used, which tries to maintain velocity, rounding corners. Unfortunately, since I had set a conservatively low acceleration value, to make the right angle over the boss was not possible in the clearance distance available, and the part was clipped. Using G61 to enable exact path mode all worked well and the part was no longer clipped. However, using G61, the mill's motion didn't have a smooth sound because the tool was visiting each endpoint regardless of the distance. A lot of short jerky motions, not really visible, but audible. While I don't know if this is the best approach, I upped the acceleration value for all three axes and switched to using G64 with P and Q options set to 1 thou. A tolerance of 1 thou is probably better than what I can currently maintain anyway. Even with this tight tolerance on G64, the velocity is maintained and the mill sounds smooth. It's clear the LinuxCNC folks have made an amazing program to learn from. The required information is in the LinuxCNC manual, but I wouldn't have understood the meaning of these commands without encountering this problem first. I hope this video helps others to avoid this mistake. Thank you.